Welcome back, everybody. In the last part, Solid Rosette took out Team Rocket and Sylph Co. by stealthily moving around the Sylph Co. building. And we took out Sabrina.
Which, by the way, we totally didn't get lost. Right?
No, I didn't get lost.
No, we didn't get lost. We didn't get lost. We didn't have to ask for directions. We didn't have to get a map. So, Andrea, don't immediately get on our case about that. We didn't have to do that. We're man. Did I take it too far?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry. That's just the way it goes sometimes.
Wow, you came all the way here? Maybe you're a Pokemaniac too. Want to see my collection?
Of subjugated people? Ugh. Can we please have more of that?
Pokemaniac Mark.
Just the lab coat adds so much flavor to that. He's in a Charizard costume with a lab coat. Because in his fan fiction, Charizard's a scientist.
Well, why not?
So I think this part, Alex, we actually kind of need to get into a little bit of business as sure. I think some listeners of the podcast, as well as ourselves, are going to have us eat some crow today.
Oh, yeah.
More like Drac is going to eat some crow today.
I think, were you the one that had the bragging rights because you thought that they were accurate? I can't remember if it was you or Romney.
I didn't think they were accurate. I don't think any of us did because it was 4chan.
Okay, so people might remember way back, there was a 4chan prophecy basically predicting a couple of releases on Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. And we all kind of promptly laughed it off because it's 4chan. You know, you can't necessarily trust everything that's on 4chan. But also, just the claims that they were making were pretty outlandish. Like, it just didn't seem like it was probable, given what we know about Nintendo and what we know about other companies involved. But today, literally today,
yeah,
Nintendo proved us wrong. As in their Nintendo Direct, their complete Smash Brothers Direct, we got a lot of major announcements, including many characters. So let's just go ahead and start this off with Simon Belmont getting announced. And by the way, welcome to the Power Plant, everybody. And that's totally not a robot. So Simon Belmont plus a Dracula's Castle final stage being announced for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Also Richter Belmont being announced. So he was kind of the one guy we didn't think was going to happen, but Simon made more sense. Then we also got the Echo character announcements of Crom from Fire Emblem and Dark Samus from the Metroid Prime series. And finally, the one that you should be excited for the most, Alex, is I think you've kind of gone on record saying, like, this is the outlandish character you've wanted besides Shantae, who's indie gaming.
Yeah.
This was, like, the established character you wanted, as King K. Rool has been announced for Smash Bros. Ultimate.
That's right.
Jiminy Christmas, man. You got your wish, and he's not an Echo. He's, like, his own character.
Yeah, it's nice.
So we already have those. We also got a lot. Basically, a lot of this was feature updates. But I'm just going to go ahead and go into my thoughts. Like, King K. Rool, that's amazing. I'm so glad that Microsoft and Nintendo were able to make a deal work to get the Kremlins in Smash.
It makes sense, I guess. They do have they have Diddy Kong and Dixie Kong.
Well, and that's kind of what I'm like. I still want like a Dixie Kong announcement. That would be awesome as far as I'm concerned.
I thought we already had Dixie.
No, but that was part of the 4chan prophecy too, I think.
Oh yeah.
So is Dixie, and basically she'd be like an echo of Diddy, but she'd have her own unique moves because of it. So let me just get into the Castlevania stuff. Simon Belmont and Richter Belmont and supposedly Dracula. I'm not
And by the way, I found the Thunder TM.
Very good, by the way. Best frickin' electric attack.
Only if it has really good accuracy.
Well, cast a Rain Dance and 100% accuracy.
Yep.
So that actually kind of encourages you to get a water electric if you can, because then you can put them both together.
I would have gotten rid of Thunder Wave then.
But yeah, so Castlevania. Simon Belmont never would have expected Richter. And I'm actually excited that Richter is in there. And I have a feeling I know why, because Simon actually mimics a lot of Richter's attacks. So I actually, like, I liked how Sakurai put this in the translation. Is like, you can't really tell who is the echo of whom, yeah, as Simon's attacks mirror Richter's, and Richter's mirror Simon's.
Oh no, it's a trap!
But we have confirmed they're separate characters. I love the fact that there has been over 34 tracks from Castlevania added into Smash Bros. Ultimate. And it's random. Like, whenever you go to their stage, you will get a new song. And one of the other things that you kind of like about Smash is when they add bosses to stages. This one has a mix of, I think, a total of 10 different bosses from Castlevania games that will come in at random. You'll only get one per fight, but it's random. So you could get Dracula, you could get the werewolf, you could get Frankenstein, could get Medusa. That's awesome. So I'm very excited for what they've been able to pull off with the character announcements. And I'm also excited about King K. Rool.
Yeah.
I think that was an awesome announcement to make. Dark Samus, not sure. Because if you were going to do Dark Samus, in my opinion, I don't want her being an echo of Samus, which is what she is. I'd want her to have her own moveset, kind of like Sheik does,
right?
Compared to Zelda. Because Dark Samus is aggressive enough that I think you could have done that. Krom from Fire Emblem, don't really have any thoughts on that, just because I'm not the biggest fan of Fire Emblem. Andrea, what's your take on the Belmonts as well as King K. Rool and all those characters being announced?
They're just nice additions, and glad that they were able to get them.
Yeah. The other thing, too, that people will probably want us to talk about is all the features that are coming into Smash Bros. Ultimate. This is probably the biggest Smash Bros. Game ever.
Yeah.
With what they're doing. They literally announced today that they have a little over 100 stages in the game. They have over 800 songs.
That's nuts.
Yeah.
And the cool part is that, you know, we're used to this happening, but like when you go to the Pokemon Stadium, you get the ba 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 ba.
Yeah.
You know, that set music. They announced today that they're going to have a bunch of tracks from Pokemon, and they're all going to be bound together with all of the Pokemon stages. So you can pick the stage, but you won't get a fixed song. It will be random.
That's cool.
So like if you pick the Skyward Sword stage from Zelda, you actually could get the Smash Bros. Melee Temple theme instead.
Awesome.
So I like that concept. The other thing, too, that they also added was the Stage Morph, which is if you have that feature on and you could choose whether or not to have it on, the Stage Morph will basically change the stage in the middle of your fight to another stage so that you can constantly adapt.
Yeah.
So you could literally start off on Final Destination and end up at Big Blue. Just out of the blue.
out of the blue. Yeah,
pardon the pun. So you have the Smash Morph, or the Stage Morph. The other added feature that I think is going to get used a lot is it's literally called Smash Down, which is you can set this up, and let's just say we have like a party of four people, and we all pick our characters, right?
Yeah.
After that match, the four characters that were picked are eliminated, and you can't pick them anymore.
Okay.
So at that point, like, you can constantly eliminate until you run out of people.
That's pretty cool.
But that adds like a whole new party strategy now. Like, let's just say you're really good at Kirby, Alex. I could pick Kirby and forever take him out of your reach.
Man.
Roughly.
Yeah.
So what I'm proposing here, Alex, is that we take Wii Fit Trainer and we forever take it away from Romney. Because we're going to have to do it. We're going to have to do Smash Bros. Ultimate that way.
He's good with Wii Fit Trainer.
He's good with a lot of characters, actually. The only one I'm trying to remember, like, there was one that he, I think it was Jigglypuff, that he didn't really like, that Romney couldn't kick our butts with. Although you guys wanted an all Jigglypuff battle.
Yeah, that was fun.
They also did make some changes to Sudden Death. So it works the same way that you think, like you're 300% damage, right?
Yes.
But now the screen will slowly zoom and fire will be on the edge. It will actually lock the walls.
Oh, cool.
So it will slowly zoom so you guys can't avoid each other. You have to fight.
Can't just play an ever long game of chicken.
Yep. And probably the biggest perk, and I promise we'll get into you guys' opinions, is the added option, you know, like with the final smashes, it's kind of an annoying feature now because you have to get that item and you have to be the one that breaks it so you get it. They now have added a different feature that basically puts a final smash gauge on your character that builds up over time, and you can get your final smash in there without having to rely on that item. The item will still spawn, but it'll just give you an instant right there.
Cool.
So out of the features that I just mentioned, like, what's your thoughts on it, Alex?
They're all pretty interesting.
It's like this game is literally built for any kind of Smash fan. If you want to play casually, you can play casually. If you want to play hardcore and give yourself challenge, you can do that too.
Yeah.
And they even actually admitted that they're basically making this as tournament verified as they can, because they made a tourney mode where you can have up to 32 individual players in it.
Nice. Too bad the tournaments won't do it. They're just going to stick with Melee forever.
Oh no, but what they're going to do with that now is like they're encouraging local tournaments to be able to do it.
Yeah.
And they're giving you the functionality to do so. So like everybody can be on their own Switch.
That's cool.
And make it work. Andrea, out of the features that got announced, like any other things that you like out of it?
Nope, I just cannot wait till it comes out.
I'll admit, when E3 had its Smash announcements, I wasn't all that excited. I thought Ridley was a cool announcement, but I was more interested in Metroid and everything like that. I'm now legitimately interested in Smash. I'm excited for it and can't wait till December. It'll be a nice game to review that will end out the year.
Roughly. Jeez, I wonder now how many characters you can play in this game.
This puts the count up. I think it's up in the upper 80s now. Because everybody's back, but now we're having all these, all of these other characters being announced. And now there is a little bit of bad news for you, Alex, because another character did get announced, but not as a character.
Oh.
Shovel Knight got announced as an assist trophy.
Oh.
So that rules him out for being a character. So, sorry about that.
Well, that's not that disappointing to me as it is to you.
Well, I know you were kind of hoping that if Shovel Knight happened, then that might mean Shantae would happen.
Yeah. So I know
means you will, if Shantae shows up in the game, it'll probably be
an assist trophy. So boring. She deserves to be a full playable character.
Yeah, I'm kind of there too, and I also think Shovel Knight deserves to be a full-on character. I think there's enough with him to make a skill set for. So that's a little disappointing, and also Capcom fans rejoice. You guys got a boss that will appear at random on stages, as well as is an assist trophy, and that is Rathalos from the Monster Hunter series. So out of nowhere, Alex, in a random stage that doesn't have bosses, you could have a big old dragon come in and just say F you all.
Oh, wow.
You could have that. Or the one assist trophy that I know everybody was screaming about, the moon from Majora's Mask.
Oh, wow.
It will literally come down and nuke the stage.
Cool.
So many Zelda fans are rejoicing at that particular aspect. But, I mean, we had tons of assist trophies also announced. A lot of new Pokemon got announced. Abra's finally making his debut in Smash Bros. This time around.
And all he can do is teleport around.
No, he creates a black hole too.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, wow.
So he literally will teleport you out to the very end of the ring to make it so you had to triple jump to go back.
Oh, nice.
So if you already used them up and you get caught, you're screwed. They also announced Solgaleo and Lunala, and both of which will annihilate the stage, or at least a certain part of it, and a bunch of Alolan Pokemon. So along with Abra, Vulpix will be making its debut, but also so will Alolan Vulpix. And let's see, the coolest one, I'll just be honest, is the Alolan Exeggutor, because he literally becomes a divider in the stage. Like, you can't go past him.
Yeah.
For a while. So like you're stuck with whomever you're fighting until he goes away. That's a cool idea, in my opinion.
Yeah.
A straight up divider. Because that basically makes it so, like, if you're getting I'm getting my butt kicked by Romney and that divider goes up, I'm screwed. Like, Romney can continue to pelt me.
Yeah.
And I can't say anything about it. But they also did announce with the stages, and we probably should say this, because I know a lot of people wanted, like, classic N64 stages and Melee stages and Brawl stages to come back. They are, but not in their classic form. They actually have been updated and balanced. So you will get Hyrule Castle from N64, but it's been updated and more balanced so that people can play this for years to come.
Right.
And with that being said, the other thing that I want to point out before people get mad at me about talking about this so much, there is so much in this game, I actually have a legit worry now, Alex.
What?
I think this is Sakurai's last Smash game. I don't think he wants to make it anymore.
I think so too.
Yeah, he's adding so much stuff that fans are asking that I almost wonder, he's like, okay, fine, I'll add that. Can I please go make something else now?
Never ask me for anything again.
Mm-hmm. I'm honestly convinced now, guys, like, this is what, Smash 5?
I think so.
Yeah, Smash 5. There won't be a Smash 6. Because I don't think Sakurai wants to make them anymore.
I haven't played any other Super Smash Brothers in a long time.
Well, because there's the classic one on N64. There's Melee. There's Brawl. That's 3. Smash 4 on Wii U and 3DS. Yeah, this would be Smash 5. And the other thing, too... Classic mode is returning from N64 Smash.
Oh, cool.
Except it's not a fixed path. Well, it's a fixed path, but it's a fixed path for every character. Every one of them is different.
Nice.
So you get a different experience from everybody.
What is with the Zapdos?
I have no idea, but the Zapdos is kicking the crap out of you.
Usually the legendaries just play defense, but this one's like offense, man.
You're gonna end
I could have sworn, like, when I did my blue playthrough, Zapdos was pretty aggressive to me, wasn't he?
I don't remember.
You probably end up using your...
I just remember using a ton of Pokeballs to try and get him.
That'd be sad if you ended up going down to your Master Ball.
I just reset the game if it gets...
Yeah, you should reset the game. I already know one thing that's happening in this playthrough. You're gonna get Mewtwo again, because yeah. you want to show that you can. Okay, Vaporeon, come on. Make your pick. Just toss out another Ultra Ball. Hopefully it'll work.
Actually,
here we go.
Moltres is probably the one that gave me the most trouble, because I had to reset. Like, that was my own dumb fault, because I didn't buy more Ultra Balls. Because it's like...
Well, Ultra Balls are expensive, man.
Yeah.
It's not like I don't understand that aspect. One. No!
How many balls?
This guy hates you. This guy hates you with a burning passion.
How many did it take you finally?
I burned through like all my balls and I had to reset.
Oh, so we're actually going to see this on camera? Resetting?
Not on this one, and Moltres. I might reset on this one. I can't remember.
One, two. No, almost at it.
Stupid Zapdos. Why don't you just go home? That's your home.
You know, we don't talk about this enough, but the game trolls you when you don't succeed, right?
Yeah.
Like, almost had it. Oh, it appeared to be caught.
Come on, are you too good for your home?
Apparently so. Be my slave! One. No! Jiminy Christmas! This Zapdos just doesn't want to go home with you, Alex. How do you feel about that?
I will make him come home with me, whether he wants to or not.
Hey, look, it can't move.
This is not the Pokemon movie universe where catching these upsets the balance of nature. I get to catch these all I like.
And then you just wait until your game cartridge, you come back, it's a barren world. It's like, wow, what happened? You caught Zapdos, and therefore the order in nature were all disrupted. You caused Lugia to rise and destroy the world. Isn't that how the prophecy goes? Lugia is supposed to come and destroy the world.
No, he doesn't destroy the world. He's there to quell the fighting. But Alola's son fails, thus the earth shelter to ash.
There is a legendary Pokemon that's like, not Giratina, like, before people get mad at me because I said Giratina in one of these. Giratina, I know he's the devil. But there is like another legendary Pokemon who's like, the bringer of destruction.
It's like a lot of legendaries.
Because I know Kyogre and Groudon are.
Yeah.
But what they basically do is, like, Groudon will get rid of the water, and Kyogre will get rid of the land. Maybe it's Rayquaza.
Might be Rayquaza.
He comes and is the destroyer of all things.
It's either that, or I can't remember which other one it was. Wasn't it, like, from...
One,
X and Y.
Two, three, boom!
Yeah, finally.
Get the ball, Bjotch!
X and Y, like the bird, or the...
I don't know, because I had Y, so I got the deer.
Yeah, because I think it...
I don't know the lore of anything past four.
Never mind, X. That's the problem. Once the games all became, like, more story-focused, pretty much all the legendaries became, like, cataclysmic.
They're either God or they're the devil. One of the two. All right, and we'll be back next time as we leave the power plant.
We'll have to continue this conversation in Emerald.
Go buy Smash.